Okay, so now we are going to do our second exercise, which is about mandatory and desirables. So you have the same facts to work with there. It's on your case study.
CET compliance.
CET accreditation. Can you answer if you have that with a yes or a no?
Yes.
Yes,
you can. And that's kind of the test you have to keep going back to, right? I said this to some people, but you have to be comparing apples to apples to apples. You can't be comparing apples to oranges because people came up with ones, but they discovered they couldn't. Yes.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah.
Because I kept coming back to the must on page, whatever page that is.
Okay.
So Mobius.
Yes.
To run Mobius, you have to have it. You have to have someone that knows what the heck they're doing.
Yep.
Well, you can't. The one that someone that knows how, what they're doing or not doing is kind of a qualitative.
Correct.
There's no real certification program for it. But to have the software is a yes or no.
Correct.
Okay.
I agree with you. See? You understand it better than you think.
That's fair enough.
So you have to have a Mobius compatible software, right?
Yeah.
And can that be answered
or
with
get
yes,
one.
No? Yeah, exactly.
Right? You have to be willing to get one.
Yeah. But you have to show you somehow have that capability. And so you're comparing, you know, vendor A can use Mobius, vendor B can use Mobius, vendor C. And it's interesting, I just had one of these where I was helping somebody. So we'll say Mobius compatibility. But it's funny because this is very typical. It was with a Crown agency who used a very, very old form of software. And the person I was looking at the proposal, or they were trying to draft a proposal, said, well, this software is so old, our software is almost not even compatible with it anymore. And I said, well, you better phone up and ask some clarifying questions. Why do they need the reporting in that format? Is there some other common software that will exchange information with that system, right? So then the purchasing agency, Crown agency, had to come back and say, okay, yes, to clarify for all you vendors, we need this to be compatible with Excel or whatever it was, right? So you can do Excel reporting so we can dump that information into whatever software system it was. So see, that made the people clarify. The Crown agency had to clarify their thinking about what was compatible. And again, all of industry had moved to something that was much newer, but the Crown agency had this older software, so you really need to make IT compatibility is huge these days, particularly with reporting, right, and information. Okay, good, perfect one. Over there in that corner, what was yours?
I don't know if this is the same as the Mobius. We weren't sure what Mobius is, but we just said an information storing database.
Okay.
Is that the same?
I would say it could be. And again, can you answer that with a yes or no?
I think, does it exist? Yes.
Yeah.
Whether or not it's like
the
one,
same thing.
You know.
That's the problem with that one, right? It's too subjective because you could have a million different incompatible systems. This is the piece that you really need to think about. Did you have another one that related to anything the service providers
needed?
We
had the accreditation as well.
Okay, sorry.
Yeah.
That was but that's a good one, right? Okay, what about in this corner over here?
50 years experience with employment supports.
Wow, that's a lot.
It is.
What if I taught surfers how to make baskets? Is that a
point? Oh, right.
Support?
So yeah, so you're giving more.
People with developmental disabilities,
yeah.
We said.
What if I taught?
Yeah.
I'm trying. Do you see my point
employment
there?
Yeah. Placement.
You gotta be more specific.
It's really hard to prove similar. It has to be exactly the same as what, where you're trying to get people to measure up to a minimum standard. Can you think of experience is always a problematic one. Can you think of another one?
What if you said something like service provider has been in operation for 10 years or something? Is that?
You could say that, but yeah, I would be more specific yet. Like in operation, what does that mean? Having a business license in Alberta? Right? Like it would have to be something really specific.
What I picked up on, because it comes from the psychological assessments or the needs assessments, was a qualified SMD and a qualified psychologist.
Yeah, because it does mention specific things. You guys were also talking about first aid or whatever those things were, right? So you need to either have someone on your staff that has those credentials. So what did we say? So anything that's a qualification, like a formal qualification, So we said psych. What were the other ones?
The other one's SMD.
SMD, is that how?
See, that's what they call the service needs determination form.
And how do you get that? Do you get that through the province? Is that like a piece of paper they'll give you for taking that course? Okay. So that's a good one because you have to prove that you have that piece of paper, right? First aid could be another one.
And I believe that's also true about employment assessment.
Probably, yeah.
Specific.
Yeah. And if you don't have these, maybe you mention you either have a partnership or a subcontractor that does these things.
The other one was first aid CPR trainers.
Sorry?
First aid CPR.
Yeah. Exactly. Okay, so those are all good ones because they're very, very specific. Was there anything else that's a mandatory? What about the actual business itself?
What we said is a registered society or a business.
Yeah, registered society or business. Because you can actually get the piece of paper that says that, right?
And we also said that you currently are able to work in that area because the PPO is specific to regions.
Okay, so how would they prove that?
No.
No, but like how would you prove you could work in the area? Oh, you mean you're ready to work or available to work? Is that what you mean? That's a tough one, though. That's I'm trying to tell you why that's wrong. That sounds bad. I think the assumption is that you are ready to work if you're even submitting yourself, right? But do you see how problematic that is? Do you see why I don't like them? Because they're so hard when it comes to experience, unless it's a credential. So in other words, the test is kind of like, can I produce a piece of paper that everyone gets the exact same thing for? Okay. So that was well done, though. You did well on that one. Okay, what about desirables? Let's start in this corner and go around again. So this was assuming, and this wasn't quite clear from the instructions, of that you could be, you might be, these would be desirable aspects, criteria for the RFP. So what would you say?
That our proposed resources meet the educational criteria.
Say that again.
The proposed resources meet educational.
Meet educational?
Yeah.
Okay. Kate, so would you have a way of measuring that? And again, remember, you don't necessarily have to be as strict on these ones, but how would you propose to measure that?
To show qualifications, like certificates or diplomas.
Oh,
or
yeah, I did.
What is your minimum hiring
and
requirement?
And this would be for who? For the
proposed
service provider.
Yeah.
So you're talking about staff?
Yeah.
Okay. So staff qualifications again. And again, when I said service provider here, it could be about the company itself as right as well. So, and this could play out as, well, just to pick an example, like say you wanted to count degrees. Everybody had a degree. I'm not saying this is a good way to see if people are qualified or not, but say for everyone who had a BA, you gave them 1 point. For everybody that had an MA, you gave them 3 points. For everybody that had a PhD, you gave them 5 points. Like that type of scoring, right? So then you're gonna, the more qualified people, you're gonna get more points. Anybody else in the corner over there? Desirables?
List the community partners you work with.
Yes, now that's a good one. Now, how would you try and measure that? And it can be any way you want. So I'm really open to what your thinking is on that one. How would you show that you had, how would you have them demonstrate, or this would be for you, how would you demonstrate that you had community partnerships?
What, letters of reference?
Anywhere you can have a third party showing, measuring something is makes it your job easier, right?
When you say we came from this, yes. Going back to Darren's, you know, 50 years of experience, which has resulted in community employer partnerships. So
yeah.
And
experience is totally legitimate here in desirables, right? Experience is great because we're assuming that with years' experience comes wisdom and all those great things, right? So experience is totally fine. That should be here, actually, because you want people with more experience. So, again, however you want to measure that, 2 years, 3 years. And you can say, You can specify too, is it similar experience? Is it with other government organizations? Right? You can measure how that experience is however you want.
Could I ask a question about that? So if you can prove track record, would that be where you would do that too? So let's say you have survey results or you have satisfaction surveys or feedback loops or something that would demonstrate that.
Yeah. If you have anything that can show this as a service provider, sure.
So what about employment? You might, employ that people who have actually been employed and maintained
Like stats.
Yeah.
Yeah, your own stats that you've collected, you could show those.
Yeah. But well, you could. Kind of they may not summarize take them seriously, right?
Yeah.
If it was a third party somehow accredited stat, that would look better, right? I was in recently in an evaluation process as a fairness monitor, and the three vendors that had presented on the in the interviews, I mean, they're like, well, we're blah blah fourth ranked. But the people that really shone were the people that a completely independent organization picked as number one favorite of all software vendors for whatever. That showed they were really credible, right? Because it had nothing to do with them, nothing whatsoever to do with them. They were able to bring in a completely independent party that ran its own evaluations and say, that said, these people are number one. It had nothing to do with them, right? So it will, they'll have to consider the source of the information. If you keep your own stats, I mean, those might be good in something like client volume or something, right? Showing capacity, because why, and they may not totally believe them, but they're better, they indicate something, right?
Like something like X amount of staff serving, Y amount of people in care, and Z amount of locations throughout the region.
Yeah, exactly. Because you're showing capacity, right? That would be a capacity question. And again, capacity is another place where you definitely want to have a desirable.
So with respect to accreditation, and I think Chris was thinking about this one, is it? Now you can say, yeah, I'm accredited, but now you can say for how long,
In
what specific areas.
Yeah, and you're going to score higher. Yes, the more areas, that's an excellent one. So, yeah, there's a place for everything. It just has to be in the right place. The problem is when people try and put these desirables in the mandatory category, it just doesn't work. Yeah, this capacity one's a good one, serving Y amount of clients at Z locations. That's a very good one. And sorry, the accreditation piece, sorry, I lost a little bit.
It was just the detail of the accreditation.
Yeah, so how many years, number of years.
What areas,
yeah.
Right? Because you have attributes attached to
them. No, that's a good one. Any other ones anyone would like to see in there?
Can you have stories? Like humans, people that were successful through your program or something?
Like anecdotal stories?
Yeah.
I think you could. I'm just trying to think in the best way that you could present that. You know, I think you would almost have to go towards a bulk measurement like client satisfaction surveys. You might have a pamphlet about your organization where people share their stories or something. You know what I mean? Like, I'm struggling with that one because it's harder to fit a narrative into something that's trying to measure volumes and amounts.
Hyperlink to your testimonies page on your
website. No, you totally could, because that gives you credibility from clients as well, right? I'd definitely try and put it in if I were you. Sure. Because it shows a certain qualitative value, right? Satisfied clients.
You can highlight the success stories and provide a reference to that success story.
Yeah, exactly. Or you could say, we had this many success stories. Here's a link to, or here's feedback, or you might even say it as a feedback. That could be a way to do it. Client feedback, because really, that is also very attractive, right? Especially if it's qualitative, because it's showing that you provide good service. Not just that you provide service, but that you provide good service. Yeah, whatever you have that shows you're good, try and think of a way to bring it in, right? Okay, good job.